Babs, I didn't realize the dance is day after tomorrow.
That's right, Mother. Saturday.
Dance? What dance? Now, Babs, I don't want you going to any dance hall.
Oh, but
will
Daddy,
you please relax.
Please, Peg, I know what goes on at them dance halls. Wrestling to music. And not only that, after the dance.
They're not going to a dance hall. This is a dance given by her class at high school.
Oh, high school dance. Well, it's different. Go ahead, Babs. You go and make a big night of it. You don't have to be home till 10.
10? Oh, be fair. She's not a baby.
You and Daddy needn't quarrel about me. I'm not going to that silly dance.
You're not? Why not?
I'm just not going, that's all.
Gosh, Babs, was it because of something I said? Gee, you don't have to take me serious. I'm your father. Just because I shoot my big mouth off, you don't have to listen to me. Now listen, Dad. You go to that dance.
Daddy, I told you, I'm not going.
Well, why not?
Well, if you must know, nobody asked me.
That's ridiculous. I just asked her.
Please, I'd rather not discuss it anymore.
That poor child, she's talked about nothing but that dance for weeks.
My own daughter, lovely and beautiful, hasn't got a friend in the world, an outlaw.
Oh, now, it isn't that bad.
There's a reason for this, Peg, and it ain't Babs' fault.
No, it certainly isn't.
I might as well be honest with you. It's all your fault.
My fault? Every time a boy comes around here, you kick him out.
Kick him out? Name one.
What about Simon Vanderhoffer?
Well, name another.
Frankie Farron.
Frankie Farron, 18 years old, and he's got a mustache.
Well, Jack Byrne, Paul Schmidt.
Well?
Freddie Yates, Eldon Ruberg. You scare them all away.
Just maybe it is my fault, but I'm only trying to protect it.
Well, you needn't, dear. This isn't 1890. Fathers have changed.
Yeah, fathers have changed, but boys haven't.
Well, you don't need to worry about that. She and I have plenty of good talks, and that girl can take care of herself.
No, Dick, this is terrible. Maybe if I called up one of the guys that I hate.
Okay. It's a pity that you won't be at the dance. I'm just heartbroken, darling. I'm sure you are, Helene. It's going to be absolutely super swank. My committee deliberately made it informal so that girls like you, who can't afford a formal gown, wouldn't be, shall we say, embarrassed.
Oh, how sweet of you, Helene.
It's really a shame that you weren't asked. Why, I had no idea that you were quite so unpopular. Of course, there's my cousin Wilbur, who works in one of my father's banks. Oh, Wilbur's so obnoxious. Of course, I could force him to take you.
No, thank you, Helene. I really don't care to go. Dances are such a bore.
Oh, good evening, ladies.
Oh, hello, Daddy. Helene,
hi, honey.
You've met my father. Charmed. Pardon my gloves.
Pardon my bare hands.
Hello, dear.
Hi, Dublin. Oh, I almost forgot. I got a date for you to take you to the dance.
A date?
Yeah.
You got me. Oh, Daddy, you and your jokes.
Come in the kitchen, please.
What for, Peg? I wash my hands at the plant. Wait till you see him, Pat. Wait till you see him. I invited him to supper. He'll be here any minute.
Well, this is interesting. Your painter arranges dates for you. Tell me, Mr. Riley, are those escort bureaus very, very expensive?
That's a hot one. You don't get any swell boys like this at any escort bureau. I picked him up off the street. I mean, well, he goes to college, UCLA. He had a flat tire, and I helped him fix it. Then I invited him over for supper.
I need you in the kitchen.
Discuss it later.
Sure, but wait till you see him. He's a real chic. He'll be here any minute.
I'm so glad for you, Babs, darling. Well, I'll be running along now.
Hey, wait a minute. I think I hear his car. Look out. Hey, come here and look at this.
I'll have to see your prince, charming. How fortunate you are that he has a A Cadillac! Daddy, it is a Cadillac.
Yeah, of course, it's last year's, but wait till you see him.
Why, he's gorgeous. Oh, he's divine.
Oh, he is handsome.
Look at those shoulders.
Yeah, not padded like yours.
What's his name?
Jefferson Warwick.
Jefferson Warwick? Of the Pasadena department store, Warwick?
Yes. That's how the Pasadena Warwicks are with the California Rileys. So if you all step to one side, I'll let him in. Your eyeballs are hanging out.
Helene, weren't you about to run along? Oh, I have a few minutes yet, darling.
Well, hiya, Jeff, my boy. Don't bother to wipe the feet. We hit our rug.
Well, I hope I'm not too early.
Nope, you're right on time. I'd like you to meet my wife.
How do you do, Mr. Warwick?
Now I want you to meet my daughter.
Well, how do you do? I've heard a great deal about
you. This is my daughter.
How do you do, Mr. Warwick?
Well, this is a real pleasure.
Well, I mean, really?
I'm sorry.
Good
I didn't
night.
Mean that. I guess I was a little rude to her.
Yeah, just a little, but it was okay for a start.
Oh, darling. Mr. Warwick, shall we go in the dining room? I'll set a place for you in a jiffy.
Yeah, as they say in Pasadena, dinner is swerved. Or every man for himself.
Hello? Who? Babs. Oh, yes, Joni, I'll call her.
Who is it, Peg?
It's for Babs. Babs, telephone! She'll be right here.
Well, if I do say so myself, I certainly did a good night's work.
No wonder. You did everything but hold a gun to that boy's head.
Well, he's taking us to the dance, ain't he? That's all that counts. When it comes to fixing the situation.
Hello? Oh, hi, Joni. What? Oh, no. Oh, no.
What's the matter?
Oh, are you sure? Oh, that's awful. Bye.
What's wrong, dear?
Nothing.
Oh, now I can tell by your face something's happened.
Oh, it's the most horrible disaster of my life. That little cat, Elaine, she deliberately had the dance changed to formal. She knows I haven't got a formal gown. She's just burning with jealousy because of Jeff. And this is her way to get even.
Of all the nasty tricks.
Gee, Babs, you can go informal. You'll still be the prettiest girl there.
Oh, I couldn't. All the other girls are going formal. I couldn't embarrass Jeff.
I'd like to wring that Elaine's neck.
Hey, wait a minute. I got it. You got a nightgown. I mean an evening gown. Gee, it'll fit you like an old glove.
Nonsense. He can't wear that old thing. I got it before the war.
Well, I won't go that far.
Oh, you'll go. You'll go, Beth.
Listen, darling, we've got to get her a formal gown. She's never had one, and now's the time.
Oh, would you buy me one? Oh, that'd be wonderful.
Okay, get her a formal gown. Take it out of the house money.
House money? Riley, I can barely get through this week. And I don't think you can even get a decent gown for less than $30.
$30? Where am I going to get 30 bucks? If an evening gown cost $5, I'd still be $10 short. Hey, when is the dance?
Tomorrow.
Oh, couldn't they put it off till Monday? I get paid then. Oh, I guess they can't. Gee, honey, I'm sorry, but I just ain't got the dough. Why don't you wear your nice black dress?
Oh, no, Jeff would hate me in that.
Wouldn't you want your date to go formal if you were Jeff?
Jeff. That's all I'm hearing. He's starting to mix up my life. I don't know why I ever let you women force him on me.
Who brought him here? Come on, Ben.
Hiya, Joe. This is your old pal, Riley. Yeah, it has been a long time. Oh, my family's swell. How's your gang? Ah, that's great, pal. Look, Joe, I'll tell you why I called. You see, well, I'm in a jam and I need $30. Yeah. What do you mean, wrong number? Joe! Hello, Henry. Hiya, Hank, old pal. This is me, Riley. Yeah. How are things, Henry? What? Three more, huh? Since I last saw you. You don't say. Gee, that's swell, Henry. I'll tell you why I called, Henry. You see, Peg and me want you and Clara to come over for dinner. Now, you say when? Sunday? Yeah, Sunday's fine.
Sure.
Oh, by the way, Hank, I called you for something else, too. I'm in a terrible jam, and I need $30. What? Henry is dead. Oh, gee, that's too bad, Henry. Wait a minute. Oh, hello?
No, no, Mr. Riley. It's always darkest before the dawn.
Fish Black, you know what?
Yes, I was listening in on the party line, and I heard you trying to borrow $30, so I came right over.
Waldo, Pat, you're going to lend me the $30.
No, but I did want to apologize for eavesdropping. You see, my wife handles the money in our family, and I just can't handle my wife.
Like Babs ain't going to get the dress. And after I had a set with a swell rich guy.
Now, now, Mr. Riley, I always say when you're caught on the horns of a dilemma, don't just sit back and take it. Jump up and fight.
You know, Waldo, this is a crazy world. When Babs was a baby, I could buy her all the clothes she needed. Now she even wears less and I can't afford it.
Mr. Riley, I have a wonderful idea. Do you have anything of value you could trade in?
Well, wait a minute. My bowling ball.
Oh, fine.
I won it at the aircraft tournament. Here, look. It's got a velvet thumb protector, soft as an oyster's belly.
Oh, really? Let me try it.
Wait a minute.
Fine. Could you bring yourself to trade this in for a gown at the economy swap shop?
Sure. Oh, wait a minute, Waldo. I don't like Babs to wear anything secondhand.
Oh, their things are like new. They've only been worn once or twice.
Well, will she look elegant?
The economy swap shop has exquisite apparel. I'll pick out a dream.
Okay, Waldo. Go ahead. Have it here tomorrow night. Gee, this is just like a fairy tale. Babs is Citronella, and I'm a fairy godfather.
Oh, fine.
You're going to be late for Jeff.
Well, I phoned him up and broke the date.
Yeah, well, I phoned him up and unbroke it.
Daddy, how could you? I told you a dozen times I can't go without a formal.
Well, what do you think this is?
Oh, is it for me?
It ain't for me. I don't go at night with a fair midriff.
Oh, Daddy. Oh, Daddy.
Oh, no, honey, take it easy.
Oh, Daddy, you're an angel. Mother, come here quick.
What is it? What's all the excitement? Where did you get that gown?
Daddy bought it for me. Isn't it stunning?
Oh, that must have cost a fortune. Where did you get it?
Well, I,
Oh, it's from Nancy's. See the box?
Nancy's?
Yeah, the box is from Nancy's.
Where'd you get the money?
Well, I figured my bowling.
Riley, you've given up bowling. Oh, you're sweet.
Well, not exactly.
Oh, Daddy, I'll never forget this. It's just my size. Oh, it's going to fit like a dream. She's so happy. Not every father would do what you did.
Well, Peg, I figured the economy.
Economy. Sometimes we have to forget about economy. You know, she never could have worn that old dress of mine. You're so understanding. Most men would never realize that a woman just couldn't bear to wear anything that was secondhand.
That's just it.
What were you going to say, dear?
Nothing.
Mother, Daddy, look. Isn't it ravishing?
Holy smoke.
Oh, I'm just mad. Darling, you look adorable. And look, it's strapless.
Hey, you can't do a rumba in that. I'll have to lend you my suspenders.
Oh, Daddy, that's the latest style. Wait till that Elaine Bidwell sees me in this.
Oh, darling, it's beautiful.
Hey, that must be Jeff. I'll let him in.
My coat, my coat. Oh, I'll carry my jacket now.
Well, good evening, son.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, Mrs. Riley.
Hello. Hello, Jeff.
Gosh, you look beautiful.
Thank you. Would you give me a minute? I have to get my lipstick.
Put on a flavor that Jeff likes.
My, you look fine.
Thank you.
Yeah, you look just like a waiter.
Have you had your dinner yet?
Well, not exactly, but I'll get something later.
Oh, come on, have some soup while you're waiting.
Yeah, come on in the kitchen.
Thank you.
Good
evening, Helene.
Good evening, Mrs. Riley.
Can I help you?
I just wanted to see Babs a moment. She's home, isn't she?
I'm afraid she is.
It's a shame she's not going to the dance tonight. She's such a delightful girl.
I think so. Well, come in. I'm sure she'll be glad to see you.
I thought that if she had to stand up her date tonight, I might help her out by allowing him to take me. After all, what are friends for?
Sometimes I wonder. Don't you have a date?
Well, of course. But I'd gladly break it. Do you happen to know where Mr. Warwick can be reached?
Yes. Oh, Jeff.
Oh, hello.
Well, hello. Why, I thought that...
Jeff, I'm ready.
Oh, Helene, what are you doing here?
Why, I said you...
She came to help you out, dear.
Help me out?
That dress.
Oh, thank you, Helene. Do you really like it?
Well, yes, it suits you perfectly. The color wasn't quite right for me.
Oh, did you try the dress on, too?
Try it? Oh, well, really, I had it made for me over a year ago, and I wore it.
Oh, if this is your idea of a joke, Helene, this dress happens to come from...
Yes, I know, the economy swap shop. I gave it to my maid, and she swapped it.
Why don't you all go to the dance? It's getting late.
You must be mistaken.
Why aren't you?
Riley.
Oh, fun is fun, Helene, but this dress was bought at Ask Nancy's. It was an original created especially for me. You'll probably find my initials.
Just a minute.
There, see?
It's a misprint.
Would you excuse me, Jeff?
You've enjoyed yourself. Suppose you go.
Good night, all. You know, it's really a shame that you missed the dance.
Could I... Would you permit me to take you to the dance?
Oh, delighted. I'll dismiss my chauffeur. Come along.
I'll be right there. Would you tell Beth...
Go on.
...that I...
Beat it.
But I...
Beat it. I'm sorry. I was only trying to help.
I understand, but I don't know if she ever will.
I think I'll take a walk. Maybe I can get run over. Oh. Hiya, Peg. Where's Babs?
Where do you think? In her room, crying for an hour.
Maybe I'd better have a talk with her. Betsy. Betsy, darling.
It'll be all right, Daddy. Just leave me alone.
Failure as a husband and a flop as a father. I get everything mixed up. I'm just no good.
Oh, stop apologizing for yourself. You're as good as anybody. I love you the way you are.
And you ain't mad at me?
Oh, of course not. You were trying to help me.
And if you ain't mad at me, why are you crying?
It's not you. It's that horrible Helene. Humiliating me like that. Oh, I'll get even with her someday.
We'll take care of her, all right. And I'll take care of her old man. I'm through doing business with his bank. Get my blood is elsewhere.
No, but what hurts the most is it all happened in front of Jeff.
Oh, what do you care about that phony? Some guy he turned out to be. Dropped you like a hot tomato.
But Mrs. Riley, I've got to see her.
Oh, it's Jeff.
You wait here. I'll take care of him.
I don't think Babs wants to see you. You'd better go.
But, Mrs. Riley, I've got
Listen,
to see
you. You got some nerve treating my Babs that way? Why, if you were any gentleman, you would have punched that Helene in the nose.
Well, I couldn't do that, but...
What's so funny?
Well, I didn't like the way Helene treated Babs, so I thought I'd teach her some manners. She insisted that I take her to the dance the long way. So I did. Last I saw her, she was 20 miles away in Glendale waiting for a bus.
You mean you made her walk home?
No.
Oh, no, no. Wait a minute, Babs. Hey, Babs, quick. Take me to the dance, darling. Hey, Babs, wait to hear this.
Oh, you better go, Jeff. I've embarrassed you enough tonight.
You didn't embarrass me. I don't care about the dress.
Oh, you're just saying that.
Well, no, I'm not. This tux is secondhand, too, and it's not even mine.
Well, what about the Cadillac?
I sort of thought you folks had the wrong idea. That's not my car. I'm just a chauffeur. That's the way I'm paying my way through college.
Well, ain't you one of the department store Warwicks?
Why, heck no. They're my rich relatives. And they just like the stuff in their stores. No bargains. I'm one of the poor Warwicks.
Gee, you ain't just saying this for Babs now.
Word of honor. Why, you see this tux? I rented it. Hey, I better get back. If I don't get it there by 12 o'clock, it's $2 extra.
Are you on a level? You ain't rich.
Mr. Riley, I only got $3 to my name.
$3? Bank! Babs, he's got $3! Oh. You're a bum! Hello, pal! How are you? $3 he's got, Bank! I got a nickel more than him!